Hey, kids and families, we're so happy to have you here with us tonight to be worshiping together at this family service. I'm Joy, and I'm from the HB campus, and I'm here with Jen tonight.
That's right. Well, we hope you guys had a great Easter. Kids, hopefully you got to decorate some eggs or do an egg hunt, and hopefully you guys all got to spend some time as a family and celebrate that our Savior is risen. We're excited for another night of our family service tonight.
This has been such a fun time for our families. We've made it a part of our regular Tuesday night routine for our family to get together around the TV and to sing and dance together and get to hear about God together. And it's just been a great connecting time for our family. And I hope it has been for yours too.
Well, let's get started and worship together.
You are alive in me.
What's up, my friends? I'm here to tell you that Jesus is risen! He is risen indeed.
That was so good, Dylan. Hey, let's give our families a joyful countdown as we start our family service today.
You got it. Here we go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
He is risen! Jess, that's where you come in.
Oh, right. From the beginning.
Okay. He is risen!
He is risen indeed!
Hallelujah! 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 Hallelujah!
Wow, Jess. You crushed it. Anyway, we're so glad that you joined us today. And this past weekend at Easter, we got to celebrate about Jesus and learn about what happened on that special third day.
Yeah, we got to see Jesus, Savior of the world, die on the cross and raise from the dead so that we can live in freedom.
Yeah, and we get to celebrate and live in this together. But as we jump back into the Old Testament today, we're going to learn again about why King Jesus had to come and save us from our sins.
Hey, Jordan.
Yeah, Jess?
What would you say if we maybe mix it up a little bit today and started off with our Family Connect time?
Well, okay.
Great. Well, we're going to play a new game today, and it's called Reallys and Sillies.
Oh, I love this game. So here's the scoop. You're going to have to think of two reallys and one silly. Now, your reallys are two true facts about yourself, and your silly is one fun thing that you get to make up to try to trick your family.
To start you guys off, Jordan and I are going to put our own reallys and sillies on the screen, and you guys have to guess at home which ones are silly.
Sounds fun. Jess, let's see yours first. Okay, so she says she's been skydiving. She was a professional kid bowler. You know, you seem like you could bowl. The alphabet. Oh, let's test her real quick. What letter comes after A?
B.
Dang it. It must not be that. She's too smart for that. So it's skydiving. Definitely skydiving. You have never been skydiving.
Wrongo. I have been skydiving, and here's a picture to prove it.
What?
I'm soaring, flying.
All right, let's just move on to the next one.
All right, it's your turn. Okay, so it says you are a scuba dive certified. You are scuba dive certified.
It's possible.
You lived in South Korea.
It's a place. I live in places.
Right. And you love Chick-fil-A more than In-N-Out.
Also plausible.
Okay. So I've seen you eat lots of Chick-fil-A whenever our team goes out to eat. So I think you actually love Chick-fil-A. I know you've lived outside of California.
Again, I live in places.
Right. So it could have been South Korea.
Could have been.
Here's the thing, y'all. I've seen some floaties on his desk before. I don't think he knows how to swim. Therefore, I don't think you're scuba dive certified.
What? Okay, I will tell you what my silly is. My silly is... I'll be right back.
Oh man, that guy's always leaving. Well, I don't know what his silly is going to be, but we'll find out later. It's your turn at home now. You guys have 4 minutes to work together as a family and figure out what your reallys and sillies are. Let's get started.
Thank you.
How does your Reallys and Sillies go at home? You know, I still don't know where Jordan's at. I'm pretty confident, though, his silly was that he doesn't know how to scuba dive or swim, so he couldn't be...
I'm back. Oh. I'm back. Sorry, I just had to run a quick errand. You might actually call it a silly errand because I wanted to show you, not tell you what my silly was. Here you go. This is for you. Can you figure it out?
Oh, so your silly was that you actually love In-N-Out more than Chick-fil-A.
You betcha. Double-double, grilled onions, lettuce, tomatoes, and Neapolitan shake all day.
That would make sense. I do have a question, though. What's with the poncho?
Well, I saw that we had, the propolis said we needed rocks today, so I thought, I'll go outside, I'll be helpful. But then I went out there and realized it's been raining like crazy.
I mean, I could have told you that. We did need rocks, though, so thank you so much for bringing some.
Yeah, so can you remind me, like, what do we need rocks for in our story today?
I'm so glad you asked. Today in our story, we are going to be learning about a false god, an altar that the people created to worship this false god, and a prophet named Elijah that God sent to lead his people back to the one true king. Oh, gross! Jordan,
no,
bless
Jess,
you!
Stop that! No, that wasn't me! I didn't sneeze! That must be our new big picture question signal.
Oh, right. Sorry about that. It's time for a big picture question. Say this week's big picture question with me. How many gods are there?
Let's now say the question and the answer together.
How many gods are there?
There is one true God who alone deserves worship. Wow. You know what? That's so true. There's got to only be one. Doesn't everyone know that?
You know, there is only one true God, but the people in our story today from the Old Testament didn't even recognize that. Instead, they chose to worship another God, a fake God, a false God named Baal.
Baal? Like basketball? Jessica, are we learning about basketball today? I love basketball. Ball is life. You know what? I even brought my Air Jordans with me today. And here's a sick picture of me playing ball. Boom.
Is that you?
Yeah, that's me. They call me the knockoff Air Jordan.
If you say so.
But still, I don't get it. Why were people in the Bible worshiping basketballs?
No, Jordan, not basketballs. Not that kind of ball.
Well, hold that for me real quick, please.
Okay.
Dribble. I need more room. A little higher. A little bit higher. Okay. Boom! Posterized. Ball is life.
Okay. I'm no longer going to pronounce it ball. I'm going to pronounce the false god's name, Baal. Today we're learning about a false god named Baal.
Oh. Baal, not ball. Baal was the tiny god. Or the little g god that Pastor Eric talked about a couple weeks ago.
Exactly. But before we go more into our story, it's time for some worship. I think it's time.
Yes, I love this part. And if you're like me, maybe you're ready to rock.
I see what you did there.
Yeah, it was pretty funny, right?
Yeah.
All right, let's get ready to worship. If you had some rocks in your hand, put them down for safety. And now it's time to get the people going. Everyone, up on your feet. Let's get it going. Are you ready? Jessica, are you ready?
I'm so ready. You guys, count down with me into worship. 3, 2, 1.
Get those air guitars out just like this. Come on, let's sing this out. My God is strong. He'll do anything big or small. Nothing is impossible for a super wonderful God. Every day I can know God is always there for me and my family. Every day I can know greater is the one who lives inside me. Super big, super strong, super wonderful God. Super big, super strong, super wonderful God. Oh, oh. Put those O's up in the air. Sing our God. Our God is strong. He'll do anything big or small.
Nothing is impossible for a super wonderful God.
Every day
I can know God is always there for me and my family. Every day I can know greater is the one who lives inside me.
Come on, let's sing.
Super strong, super wonderful God. Super big, super strong, super wonderful God.
It is so much fun worshiping with you tonight. Our next song is about how God's love surrounds us. Even when we don't feel him close, he's here. So come on, let's worship together. Clap those hands. Sing this out.
Surrounded, surrounded. Your love is everywhere and I'm surrounded. It's got me singing, it's got me shouting. And now I wanna tell the world about it. Cause now I am alive, yeah, you opened up my eyes. Everywhere I look I see,
come on, let's sing.
Your love for me,
it makes me wanna lift my hands, dance
and sing.
Oh, 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 your love for me. No matter where I go, I know you're there for me. Surrounded, surrounded. Your love is everywhere and I'm surrounded. It's got me singing, it's got me shouting. And now I wanna tell the world about it. Cause now I am alive, yeah, you've opened up my eyes. Everywhere I look I see.
Come on!
It makes me wanna lift my hands. Love for me, no matter where I go, I know you're there for me.
Oh, oh, oh,
oh.
Your love
for me.
Oh, oh, oh.
Now I am alive, yeah, you've opened up my eyes. And everywhere I look, I see.
Come on, sing it out.
And now I am alive, yeah,
you've
opened up my eyes.
Everywhere I look, I see. Your love for me. It makes me wanna lift my hands,
dance and sing. Oh, oh, oh.
Your love for me. No matter where I go, I know you're
there.
We're gonna jump. Oh, one, two, three, four.
Your love for me.
It makes me wanna lift my hands, dance
and sing.
Oh, oh, oh. Your love for me. No matter where I go, I know you're there for me.
Wow, guys, I'm having so much fun worshiping with you. We have one last song, and this one's a new one. It's called Thankful. And in the chorus, it says, I want to be thankful, I want to be grateful, and I want to remember all the things that the Lord has done. It's so easy to forget all the good things God has done. So let's sing this out like we believe it. Come on. Snap those fingers. Come on, let's sing this out.
I like to think about the goodness of the Lord. He
gives me everything I need and so much more. So I just wanna lift my hands and say that I love him. I just wanna lift my heart in praise. And I wanna be thankful, I wanna be grateful. I wanna remember everything that the Lord has done. I wanna be thankful, I wanna be grateful. I wanna be.
All right, let's sing this out.
I like to think about the goodness of the Lord. He gives me everything I need and so much more. So I just wanna lift my hands and say that I love him. I just wanna lift my heart in praise. And I wanna be thankful, I wanna be
of you guys. Well, I love when we get to worship together. Now for all my preschoolers, can I see you put your hands out? Wiggle your fingers. We're going to go open and shut them, open and shut them. Give them a little clap, clap, clap. Now everyone, let's pray together. Dear God, help us to trust in you, for you are the one true God. Thank you for loving us so much. And in your precious name, amen.
You guys look so great out there worshiping God. Man, I wish I had some dance moves like you guys. It's time for our Bible story. Are you ready? I sure am. Let's get started.
Hey kids and parents, families, it is so good to be back with you. If I didn't get to meet you last week, my name is Kyle, and I'm just excited to get to look at the Bible with you right now and to talk about God's story. You know what I loved last week? I love asking you the question, if you could ride on anything, what would you ride on? Some of you shared your answers with me on Facebook. Some of your parents even texted me. Maybe my favorite one was a unicorn. A little girl said she would like a unicorn that turns into a Lamborghini. Now that is an amazing thing to ride on, right? Well, I want to start with a question again tonight. So I want you to get your mind thinking. I want you to get your mind thinking, okay? All right, let's say that you have some time alone. Maybe it's in your bedroom, maybe it's in the backyard. Maybe you even have like a special place that you go to just to kind of be alone right now. Think about that for a moment. Now let's say you knew God was with you and you could ask him to do something. If you could ask God to do anything, what would it be? I want you to think about that. We're gonna give you some time. If you could ask God to do anything, what would it be? Take some time and think about it. Go. Okay, I want you to share with folks in the room, and even if you're by yourself watching it right now, just kind of speak it out. If you could ask God anything, what would it be? Well, there's a story in the Bible. Hold on to that answer, okay? Because there's a story in the Bible of a man named Elijah, and he was a prophet of God. Now, do you know what that word prophet means? It means someone who speaks for God or who tells the people about God. And he wanted God to do something. In fact, God wanted him to give a message to his people, Israel. A couple weeks ago, we talked about Solomon. Do you remember that? And Solomon was a king, but at the beginning of his reign, he was following God. But by the end of his reign, he was actually worshiping created gods, false gods. Pastor Eric talked about it. He called them lowercase g gods. And what happened, folks, is those gods have no power. They are not alive. They are things that we invent and we make up. What happened was, after Solomon died and the next king came and the next king came and the next king came, they kept on worshiping those false lowercase g gods. Then it came to this king, and his name was Ahab. Not only did he worship those false gods, he actually led the people into worshiping those gods. They didn't care about the real God anymore, the true God, the alive God, the powerful God. So God gave them a drought. Do you know what a drought is? It's when there's no rain, like none, zero. Do you know how long it lasted? Not 1 month, not 1 year, 3 years. For 3 years, it did not rain. And so crops didn't grow. They didn't have food to eat. Things didn't grow so they could feed their animals. They were like, they needed rain. So Elijah, the prophet of God, he came to the people and he said, you've forgotten the one true God and you've worshiped these false gods. He's like, I want to show you who the one true God is. So do you know what he did? He set up a contest. He set up a contest between the one true God and then this false god that the people worshiped, and they called him Baal. And what he said is, he said, I'm going to go get a bull, and the prophets of Baal, the false god, they're going to get a bull. And they're going to ask Baal, even though he's fake and false, they're going to ask Baal to come down and incinerate, to burn up their bull. And then I'm going to do it with the real god after they're done. And so the people are watching, right? Because they want to see who the true God is. And so the prophets of Baal, they get a bull and they put it on an altar. And they said, they ask Baal, come down and incinerate this bull, light it on fire. But there's no real Baal. It's not a real God. There's only one God. And so nothing happens. They get a little nervous, right? And so they start to dance, they start to do anything they can to try to get Baal to light this bull on fire. Now, fire is a difficult thing to just make happen out of thin air. Like, just look at this candle here. I have to have a lighter, I have to have a wick that will burn, and then I get a flame, right? But it's really easy at first to put out a fire because you just need a little water. It's gone. Well, do you know what happens? After the prophets of Baal cannot get Baal to light that bull on fire, it's Elijah's turn. And he has his bull. And do you know what he does? He decides to pour water all over it. Like, he takes 4 huge jars and just dumps it all over the bull. It just says it's coated in water. There's pools and lakes of water around the bull. Can you believe that? How is that ever going to light on fire? Can that even light on fire? Well, he calls out to God and he prays to God, the one true God, not a false, fake, made up God. And our God comes down, and the Bible says that it incinerates the bull, that it dries up all of the water, that it even burns the sand into ash. That is how powerful and true our God is. See, what God used to do is he would use prophets to tell the people and show the people just how powerful he was. But do you know what? We actually don't need the prophets because we have Jesus. See, the prophets, when they would ask God, God, could you do anything? They would ask him, would you show the people that you're alive? So he came in Jesus. We just celebrated Easter, right? Do you remember what happened at Easter? Jesus died. And it seemed impossible that he could rise again. It seemed impossible that he could come back to life. Just like it seemed impossible that God could bring fire where something was soaking wet. But he did. That's why we celebrated. That's why we partied. That's why we thanked God. Because when he shows up and shows us he's alive, shows us he's the one true God, he does it in the most incredible way when he sends his son, Jesus. Now, what I want to do is I want to pray for you. I want to pray for everybody, the adults watching, the kids watching, for me, that what we would find hope in is that our God is alive, the one true God, and he is working powerfully through his resurrected son, Jesus. Will you pray with me? God, thank you for these families. Thank you for these kids. God, all of us will be tempted to follow and worship false lowercase g gods. But just like you did, God, way back when through Elijah, you do now through Jesus. You show us that you are alive and that you are the only one true powerful God. Would we believe that? Would our hearts trust that? We say all this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Wow, Jessica, there's a lot of power coming from that story.
So much, but it didn't matter how much the prophets were crying out to Baal. Baal couldn't save them because he was not God. Only God has the power.
Yeah, this story shows us that only God had the power to burn the altar, to burn the bull and the water. Only the one true God could defeat the prophets of Baal.
Yeah, so Jordan, what does that mean for us?
Well, Jessica, much like Elijah believed in God's power, so do we. Actually, Easter is a lot of us celebrating God's power.
Yeah, we celebrate that God conquered sin and death.
Exactly. The same God that Elijah believed in is the God that we believe in, that same God that loves us and sent Jesus for us.
It's time for our big picture question. Say it with us.
How many gods are there?
There is one true God who alone deserves worship. You know what? I think it's also time for our memory verse, and I want to invite our pal Dylan out here to help us out. You want to come out and help us, Dylan?
I'd love to, on the count of three. One, two, three. Long ago, God spoke to the fathers by the prophets at different times and in different ways. In these last days, he has spoken to us by his Son. God has appointed him heir of all things and made the universe through him. Hebrews 1:1-2.
Wow. I don't know what it is about that guy, Dylan, but I really like him.
Yeah, he's pretty cool. I also love my girl, Mia, and I'm sure we'll see them again next week.
Potatoes, potatoes.
You know what? I think we should add some hand motions to our memory verse.
Yes, let's do that.
Follow along.
All right, on three. Three, two, one. Long ago, God spoke to the fathers by the prophets at different times and in different ways. In these last days, he has spoken to us by his Son. God has appointed him heir of all things and made the universe through him. Hebrews 1:1-2.
Wow, those hand motions were super fun. I have a challenge for you guys at home. This week, I want you guys to send us videos of you doing the hand motions to the memory verse. And the cool thing about it is that Jordan and I are going to pick two families who send us a video in, and they're going to receive a prize. So make sure to tag us at Mariners Kids so we can see them.
This sounds so fun, and I can't wait to worship with you guys next week.
See you guys next time.
It was so great to learn together with you guys tonight. Before we go, kindergarten through fifth graders wanted to share with you a special event that is just for you, online, of course. We're going to have an online game night, Thursday night, April 30th. You can invite your friends. You can register online, so make sure you go to our website and search game night. It's going to be so much fun. Another thing we've been doing these last few weeks are online small groups. They've been so much fun. Joy, you want to share a little bit about them?
Yes, my son has
been so enjoying his time meeting with his teacher and the other kids in his group over the last couple of weeks. It's been so good for him, even as a first grader, to be able to connect in that way in this time when there's so much social distancing. We just want to make sure that connection is happening. And his teacher has been awesome, and she made up a video tonight to tell you guys a little bit about what her experience has been over the last couple of weeks with the kids.
Hello, Mariners families. My name is Miss Jen, and I'm blessed to participate in the kindergarten to first grade small groups online. We've had a few Zoom online sessions over the past few weekends, and it has been so special to see their sweet faces and to watch their excitement as they see their friends, which is so important right now. In our group, we've had some fun activities like solving riddles and also some simple drawing challenges, and I've loved hearing them share what they're learning earlier in the week with the family online services. It's so great to see them reach out and share with each other what they're learning about Jesus. I would encourage anyone who's thinking about signing up their school-age children, and even the younger ones like my kindergarten and first graders, to please do. It's not too late, and all of these small group leaders are more than happy to help in any way they can. I look forward to seeing you online.
So parents, I encourage you to sign your child up for an online small group. It's for kindergarten through fifth graders every single week. You can go to our website to register them there. Have a great week, and we'll see you next time.